What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're talking about those wigs under $20 from Amazon that make you look like a third part of the Beatles, backup singers or something like that. But we're going to work on how you can change the style without just plopping it on your head and making your crown look more like a We want it to actually look like a crown. And you see, I'm taking it out of the bag. There are no combs or anything in there, and I'm looking at it like, this does not look like the picture at all. I mean, you can see the look on my face, and I'm gonna put it on my head to see what it looks like when you first try it. Girl, it does not look anything like the picture. And we seem to have that problem often when it comes to purchasing wigs online, and you're like, How can I make this work? I gotta make it work. So, I mean, the foundation of it is there. Everything is there. I mean, you can work with it with just, you know, how I'm doing right here. But I figured, let me figure out a design. I have the foundation. Let's make this really work. And that's what I want to do. So I got my razor, got the comb there, and some scissors, or shears, I should say. But yeah. We don't want this because it doesn't even look like that. So I'm going to go ahead and put it on the mannequin head, brush everything out, the tangles as much as I can, and try to figure out where to start my foundation the way that I had set it up when it was on my head. As you can see, I'm going ahead and cutting with the razor. Now, here's the thing with the razor. Razors give you a jagged cut. Scissors give you a straight line blunt cut. And what I'm doing with the scissors in certain parts, as you see in the video, is I'm giving it that blunt cut, and then I'm cleaning it up to give it that jagged edge with the razor. And those are those razor combs that you could purchase on Amazon, just like I purchased the wig, the shears I had a long time ago when I purchased from Sally's. But I'm going at an angle. Now, the reason why I'm going at an angle is because I want to give it layers. The other thing that if you're noticing, and I'm still working on the front here because I want that front side to be, you know, kind of cut short, and then I'm blending the rest to the back. But the reason why I'm working at an angle is because I want to have different layers that look full, that are jagged, and it's not a blunt cut at all. So it's at a 45 degree angle, which is how I'm holding the hair. And you can see how heavy one side is. The left side is heavier than the right, the part that I've already cut or trimmed. And the other side, it has not been cut yet. And that's what cutting does. You know, it's taking the bulk of what weighs the hair down. Even though this is synthetic, you can still do the same thing that, you know, when you go to a salon, you're taking the bulk out. You're taking that weight out of what makes hair look so heavy and flat and doesn't give it any kind of texture. Texture is something that you guys are going to hear a lot coming from my channel. Nothing but texture. And with this razor cut, I'm giving you texture, honey. I'm giving you layers that are jagged, but I'm also making it look full. Also, what you see here is I'm doing the side still, and I'm going to be working on this for a minute. It's not like I'm taking my, you know, putting it on my head, giving it a little cut here or there. No, we're gonna work with this wig to make this wig look gorgeous, Dolly. Gorgeous. So again, angles, 45 degrees sometimes. I might pull it from the top and go at an angle, but I'm still laying the hair down at 45 degrees, excuse me, to cut it, so that it has different layers within. The other thing is, I'm not doing a wet cut. You can do a wet cut, but I want to be able to see every layer that I'm doing. You can do it when it's wet, but I mean, this is synthetic. Go ahead and do a dry cut on it, and it's going to be able to show you the fullness, the body that you're looking for when you're doing a razor cut on dry hair. The other thing is, I'm not going too close to the root. And I'm also not parting, you know, in the four parts that you hear about in cosmetology school, you know, with the clippies or anything like that. I'm doing that because on wigs, the hairline is not like our hairline when it's close to the scalp. You know, you have layers, you could see those layers when it's connected to the cap itself in the wig. And what ends up happening if you cut it and part it like you would your hair, you're gonna end up with something very choppy that is not full. And it also has a, it won't cut the way that you want it to. So I'm not doing any sorting. I'm taking it piece by piece, picking it up, cutting at a 45 degree angle, either towards the left or towards the right, or should I say towards the front or the back. When you cut towards the front, you'll have body going towards the back when you run your fingers through it. When you cut towards the back, the waves in the body or the texture will be pulled towards the front. I hope this is making sense. It's kind of hard to explain it if you have not been to cosmetology school, but I mean, you can see the difference. So you see how it's feathering towards the back, the way I pull through, that's exactly what I'm talking about. So if I cut it, see this 45 degree angle, and I'm pulling it towards this way, first for the bottom to pull out the bulk, and then I'm going to pull it towards the front and then towards the back, because I want that texture and body to have different flows or feathers when I'm cutting. See right there, that's to the front. So when I brush it back or pull it back, the feathers lay a certain way, or the hair lays a certain way. So that's just a little trick, just in case if you guys wanted to know that. I'll be showing more of that in different videos. This is just the first wig of many. I went through Amazon and found as many cheap wigs as possible. And we've all seen the try-on ones, but what do you do after you try it on and it doesn't look the way you want it to? You gotta play with it. I play with this. I really played with it. I saw the foundation and I wanted to make it work. Here we are again at the front, and I'm just cleaning out the sides and that front bang and the side to make sure it flows better. Now it's time to try it on, boo. Look, when I try stuff on, when I put it back on my head to make sure that this is what I want to retouch, I just throw it on my head looking kind of crazy. But hey, look at that cut. Baby, these are the stragglies. This is why I put it back on my head, because I'm going to clean this up. But look it. Nothing like the beginning. Nothing at all. See, and you have those layers there. Girl, I am very pleased. But I'm cleaning it up, getting some stuff done, working on that side with that one piece that was hanging down and was like, girl, you know you too long. Fix me in the back. And then the front part, it was still in my face. So those bangs I had to clean up again. See, blunt cut with the scissors. That's a blunt cut. The line is straight. But in order to clean it up, I'm going to come back through with the razor to make it a jagged edge. Blunt cut. Got it the right length there. And then, boom, here's the razor again. That little razor comb. Jagged edge. Look at that. Oh, my God. Girl, and I cut a lot of hair out. That's fine. But this is what I wanted. I wanted something that would fit my head just right. See, I'm cleaning out those blunt cut edges and giving it that jagged edge again. You can still kind of see it, but that's why I'm working with it. Some more head down, work it out. Work it out. And I got hair all on me. You know, that's the downside, but hey, it's the ultimate end result that I want for $16.99. And not having to actually send a salon, and boom, baby, did you see that back? Hold up, let me show you again. Look, girl, look at body. Give me body, give me body, yes. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Don't just put that wig on your head unless if you just want to. Hair pieces could be even more. You just gotta see the foundation. Look at that before. Look at the after. Smooches!